face. Zodiac Oracle Reading. I wasn't thinking about making any serious reading. I took a quick look at the booklet, and there are different techniques that you can use to play this. So I was thinking, reading some of the meanings of the cards for you guys. So, some of the techniques are when you ask a question or think about in your life, and then you draw the cards and then you read their meaning. Another way of playing is shuffle the cards and put them around like the 12 houses, and then in this booklet you have houses where they're at, like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, and then the card you got on one, whatever that card is in your finances house or something, or love. Oh, here it is. So, the first house is your self-image, personality, ambition, drives, and body. Second house, your value systems, material possession, and financial attitudes. Third house, the way you communicate, think, and learn, and so on. So I'm thinking about doing it this way now with you guys. See what happens. We have three types of cards. The back of them is the same, and then we have the zodiac signs. Oops, excuse me. We have all the zodiac signs. Then we have Mercury, Venus, blah blah blah, Earth, and then we have the elements, water, air. So, I'm going to shuffle these cards and then draw them in the houses' locations. Astrology for me is still learning subject, even though I enjoy it very much. Everything is still very new for me, so I apologize if I'm saying any wrong terms or something. Also, found out that these cards are really not easy to shuffle like regular playing cards. Too thick, but really close together. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, and 12 is this one. So you can put the rest here, the box. Now, so let's start on my house number one. Is my self-image, my personality, ambition, drives, and body. Let's see which one I got. And it's Leo. I doubt it though. I'm the opposite of Leo when it comes to my self-image. But let's see what the book says. Leo. Sign. It is a fixed sign. The key phrase is I will. And so it says, the passionate energy of fire gives life to the fixed focus quality and says, remember your sovereignty. Sovereignty. I don't know. I know what it means, but I can't pronounce. Express your natural leadership qualities. This is no time to be shy, but instead accept the spotlight. The key phrase, I will, says it all. Your will shall be done because you will make it happen. Ask yourself, how can I shine? Gather all your courage and confidence and create your reality. Leo energy is all about confidence and taking your rightful place as king of the jungle. But you are not really the boss of anyone else, and you are not infallible. Avoid arrogance. Okay, so I don't know if obviously it says that it's in the moment that I'm living, so maybe my self-image for sure not this, but maybe my ambition and drives, who knows. Okay, second house is your value systems, material possession, and financial attitudes. And we got Venus. Venus. Beautiful card. Look. Wow. I love it. Okay. Let's read Venus. Possessions, financial attitudes. Venus is associated with Venus, the goddess of love, fertility, and beauty. Venus is all about what you value, such as money and possessions, but also your ideals. Love, relationships, and partnerships are also indicated if the Venus card is revealed. So it says here that it is all about what I value, such as money and possessions. So I guess it makes sense with the second house. Who knows? We're just playing. Third house. The third house is the way you communicate, think, and learn. Siblings and neighbors. Let's see what I got. Mars. This is the masculine side of people. Whereas Venus is the feminine. That's funny. So for my third house, which is the way I communicate, think, and learn, siblings and neighbors, maybe I am a little bit like a man in that aspect. Mars. Mars is associated with Mars, the god of war. Mars represents some very powerful drives, such as competitiveness, assertiveness, and aggression. Issues about courage, confidence, passion, and strength are also part of Mars' domain. So, the way I communicate, think, and learn is competitive, assertive, aggressive. Oh, well, I don't think I'm like that, but who knows? Maybe I am, at least in this moment. Okay, fourth house. The fourth house is your mother and father, your roots, your domestic life and family. And I got Sagittarius. It's funny because my mom is Sagittarius. But we'll see what it says. My family house, domestic life and family house, mom and dad, roots, Sagittarius. Let's go. It is also a fire sign, but it's a mutable sign, and the key phrase is I perceive. Fire's strong drive strives to stand out from the crowd as it rests in the mutable go-with-the-flow quality. The key phrase, I perceive, means there is motivation to look around, to discover your own individuality while finding your place in the world. In this situation, ask, how can I best be true to myself? Be honest with yourself and with the rest of the world. Sagittarian energy is said to be a mile long, an inch deep, as well as self-involved. Slow down so that you can perceive the depths as well as the breadth of the situation. Avoid careless unkindness. If there's one thing that I am not with my family, is careless and unkind. But I feel like this is going all wrong, but we'll see. It's just for fun anyways, and I'm repeating myself now, but okay. The fifth house is my creativity, affairs of the heart, fun, hobbies, social life, and children, which I don't have right now. Affairs of the heart, maybe. Hobbies, I'm not doing much. Social life, not doing much because COVID. But I got Cancer for that, which makes sense. But let's see what it says. My God, I'm loving these cards. Look at this giant crab man in the bottom of the ocean, because Cancer is a crab. I love it. Okay. Let's go to read Cancer. Cancer is a water sign and it's a cardinal sign. The key phrase is, I feel. The sensitive energy of water finds strength and direction through the cardinal take charge quality and reminds you that emotional intelligence plays a huge role in shaping relationships and life. The key phrase, I feel, means that the motivation comes from your emotions. In this situation, ask, what feels right? Take the emotional temperature of the situation before acting. Feelings are complicated things. We often confuse our actual emotions with the stories we tell ourselves about those emotions. Those stories can distract us from the actual feeling. Avoid emotional manipulation of yourself and others. Related to social life, children, affairs of the heart, creativity. That kind of makes sense. It's a very Cancer house for some reason, in my view. Okay. Sixth house. Your job, responsibilities, work habits, and relationship, and health. Taurus. Taurus. For job, health. Job, health, work habits and relationships, responsibilities. Oh my, let's see. Taurus. It is an earth sign, which is good for job and relationships. I mean, job and responsibilities related, work habits. It is a fixed sign, and the key phrase is, I have. The stable energy of Earth combines with a fixed, determined quality and advises practical planning. Gather the facts, understand the data, figure out the next best step. The key phrase, I have, means that the motivation is centered on resources and to best deploy them. In this situation, ask, what do I have and how I can best invest it? Make a plan and commit yourself to seeing it through. Determination is a great quality, but if taken to an extreme, it can lead to disaster. While you are being advised here to make and commit to a plan, be flexible enough to modify it if need be. Avoid stubbornness. Okay. I like that for my job and work habits, responsibilities house. But I am a little bit stubborn when it comes to plans. Like sometimes when a plan changes, like last minute, I get so frustrated. It's really difficult for me, but got it. Thanks for the advice. Now the seventh house is business and romantic relationships. How you interact with people. Let's see. Libra. Libra is a very emotional and sexual, I think. And it's all about justice, which Aquarius is too, which is me, but I like this one for my romantic relationships and business relationships and how I interact with people. Libra is an air sign and a cardinal sign. The key phrase is I balance, which I think I am in my business relationships and romantic relationships. I always try to balance things. The discerning energy of air takes on the cardinal solvent quality and encourages identifying and solving problems. The key phrase, I balance, means that fairness, justice, and everyone getting along are the primary motivational drives. In this situation, ask, how can I manifest fair and stable balance? Ideals are beautiful things and very good guides. Ideals are great guiding stars, and the desire for fairness, commendable. However, in the real world, ideals rarely exist in pristine form, and justice elusive. At some point, decisions need to be made. Avoid indecisiveness. Interesting. For business and love. Very interesting. Now, eighth house. The eighth house. Jointly controlled money and assets, taxes, inheritances, and obligations. Oh yeah. I'm not really... Well, we'll see. And I got Virgo for that. Wow, this is a good one because it's organization. For controlled money and assets, taxes, inheritances, and obligations. I don't know if I'm like that, but we'll see. Virgo. It is an earth sign, but a mutable sign. The key phrase is I analyze. The realistic of earth creates a stable eye of the storm center in the swirling mutable energy and suggests shutting out all distractions in order to properly analyze the situation. The key phrase, I analyze, clearly states the motivation in this situation. In this situation, ask what can be ignored and what must be attended to. The details matter. Analysis is a great skill, as is paying attention to details. However, taken to an extreme, those gifts can become traps of pettiness and obsessiveness. Avoid being overly critical. But I like it that analysis and paying attention to details is in my money and assets and taxes house. Very good. Ninth house. Spirituality, religion, morals, higher education, and long-distance travel. That's not happening right now. But okay, spirituality, we're going to focus on the spirituality, religion, and morals. Nine. Earth. Look how beautiful. Oh my god, I think this is one of my favorite cards. Is gorgeous. Mother Nature. Earth. Taking some time here because I really like this card. Okay, so for spirituality, religion, and morals. Earth. Okay. Stable, secure, and abundant. The energy of Earth nurtures life and promotes long, leisurely pleasures. The things we need, the things we want, and the material and temporal things we value are expressed here. The acquiring and distribution of resources is at the center of Earth energy. Bring the quality of Earth to a situation through generosity, of your material goods, resources, and time. The earth is slow and sure, so take an unhurried, calm approach and avoid sudden or unexpected actions. Create a calm place in the center of chaotic energy. That's very nice, actually, for spirituality, I think. Yeah, I like that. Now, the tenth house, your public image and career, relationships with authority figures. Ooh. Air. So air is my public image right now, and career, and my relationships with authority figures, which I don't have any, but if I did, this card is what would be representing it right now. So, air says crisp, ethereal, and decisive. The energy of air fuels the winds of truth and whispers grand insights. Clarity and truth are supported by rationality, reason, common sense, and logic. Air energy breaks stalemates and stagnation through wise decision making and mutual understanding. Bring the quality of air to a situation by seeing things as clearly and objectively as possible. Focus on the facts and not the stories we like to attach to the facts. Truth, calm communication, comprehending the points of views of others, and promoting understanding of all sides. Wait, I forgot what the 10th house is. Public image and career. Relationships with authority figures. I'm a little confused, but I will read it again later. Let's go to the 11th house. Friendships, memberships in groups, hopes, goals, and wishes. I like this house. The sun. Wow. Powerful. Friendships. Hopes, goals, and wishes. Oh, my son, I love it. Okay. Here. The sun. The sun is strongly associated with your birthday, the day you came into being, and represents the need to express your sense of self. Other issues involve variations of this, such as self-image, self-esteem, individuality, identity, and personal creativity. Ideas about paternal figures and authority might also be indicated if the Sun card appears. Okay, for my goals and wishes and hopes and friendships, I don't get it. I think I'm tired and I can't really process the things I'm not being able to connect them anymore for some reason. Now, the last one, 12th house, your inner self, dreams, secrets, the past, subconscious, and karma. And I got my sign, Aquarius. at him. Oh my god, I love it. Okay. So again, Aquarius is for my inner self, my dreams, my secrets, the best, subconscious, and karma. Wow. Let's read Aquarius. Oh no, our best. It's an air sign, it's a fixed sign, and the key phrase is I know. The communicative energy of air finds determination in the fixed, stick-to-it quality. You may not have answers, but you have a network available to you. Use it, and the answer to everything is at your fingertips. The key phrase, I know, is a little misleading. You don't necessarily know the answers, but rather, you know how to find them. In this situation, ask, who has the information I need? Also, Google is your friend. I know, right? Having big visions and loving ideas makes for great conversations, but can leave a relationship empty of human emotion and other feelings neglected. Avoid being distant, detached, and cold. These are the characteristics of Aquarius that I don't see in myself, and maybe it's because of my ascendant is Taurus, I don't know. But this is for my inner self, my dreams, my karma. It's very interesting. Very, very interesting. Anyways, guys, I like this. Even though I got confused at certain points, I enjoyed reading these with you and discovering these little things. I hope you enjoy this video. And let me know if you have any suggestions or requests for me in the comments below. And I will see you in my next video. Thank you so much for watching. Have a good night.